Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Alright, in this video we're going to create our ugly looking desktop menu, which we'll style in the next video, but when it gets down to tablet and mobile, hey, it turns into a nav sandwich. So let's go and do that now in Dreamweaver. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is we're going to, in this video, put in like the core components and turn them on and off for the different views. After that, in the next video, we'll look at doing the JavaScript that makes the kind of click action happen. So when you click it, the menu drops down. And in the last video, or at least the third of this little chunk here, will be styling it just to make it look pretty. So the first thing we need to do is add our navigation. And it's this navigation tag here. I want it to be just after this image. So I'm going to click on this image. And remember, there's an image, but that image is inside this A tag. Okay, that is the link that we put around it. So click it up here, click the image, and we're going to click down here and say the A tag that's actually around the outside of this image. We want it just after you, please, and say navigation, click on him, say I would like it after the thing I have selected, and there it is there. First thing I want to do with navigation is add a style to it to get it to float to the right, because I don't want it underneath here, I want it in the top right here. So go to CSS Designer. Under styles.css, I would like it in global, I would like a selector please, called nav, and I'm going to use the up arrow. Okay, remember specificity, okay, just means that it's saying the nav tag, which is inside the header, which is inside the container. I don't need to worry about that because I've only got one nav tag for this whole document, so I don't need to be that specific. And I'm not going to say specificity anymore in this course because it's really hard to say. Okay, so I want the nav tag please to float to the right. Float is this one here. Okay, and I'm going to say float to the right. And he kind of just jumps over to that right hand side of the page. Awesome. Now, next thing I want to do is I want to put two div tags inside of this navigation. One div tag is going to be for my mobile menu, which is going to be my burger menu, that stripy line thing. And the desktop view is going to be those colored buttons that say about us and contact us. So basically what happens is you have two separate div tags, one with the mobile menu in it and one with the desktop menu in it. And you just say turn one off when we're at mobile view and turn the other one on. Okay, and switch around when we're at desktop. So let's go insert those div tags. So I've got nav selected. I'm going to go to insert. I'm going to click on div. I'll nest it inside, please. Okay, and we've got a new div tag. You can see it there. There's my nav. Okay, and there's the guy that's inside. Do we need this text anymore? We don't. I like to delete the text here in code view. Okay, deleting it in live view works most of the time, but I find it's a little bit easier to do in code view. So you can see there's my nav tag opening and closing, and there's the div tag inside of it. I need two of these. What I can do is, over here, I can select on that div tag. I can say another one, please, just after him. There he is. So now I have two. Let's put in the different components. In this first one here, I'd like to insert an image, which is going to nest inside. And I'd like it to be my burger menu, which is under exercise files, images. And we're going to use the SVG version, burger menu. You can use PNG. SVG is the newer scalable vector graphic version. Okay, let's click open. And it's going to say, you've selected something outside. Would you like to put it in there for you? You say, yes, please put it in with my images. There, please. Because I've practiced this one already, okay, to make it super slick for this video, I've already got mine there, so you won't have to click replace. You'll notice it's very big, okay, so with it selected, I can say, hit the little menu here and say, actually, I just want it to be 25 pixels. You decide how big you want yours to be. Awesome. Next thing I want to do is get rid of that text. And like I said, I like to delete the text here in code view. I don't need that text anymore. Okay, so I've got a div tag and it has my image inside. Let's put in the desktop version. Okay, so inside this guy, can I click on him? There he is there, that div tag. I'm going to put in something called an unordered list. This is how we describe lists, okay? And a navigation is just a list of options you can go to in a page. So to select on this div, and I'm going to say insert HTML, I'm going to find this one called unordered list. An ordered list is a numbered list, and an unordered list is a bullet pointed list. So you can see bullet points. We're going to remove those from the styling a little bit later on. So what I want to do is I want to change this text. OK, Okay, I want to say this one's going to be the About Us. I've used capitals, you don't have to. Return, okay, and Contact Us. It might be me. Contact me, about me, because it's just my portfolio. Anyway, so I'm going to click out. You can see I've got two bullet points, okay, and let's have a look at the how these are constructed. So there's the div tag, okay, and inside of that is my unordered list, okay, and then you can see the beginning and ending. And inside this unordered list are the list items, okay, so these are the different bullet points. That's just how it's constructed, and it's going to be important for when we later on and go and start styling them. What I'd like to do while we're here is to give them hyperlinks. So I'm going to double click about us or about me and click on this one here. See, it goes orange, click on the hyperlink, and where's this going to go? It's going to go to hash. Okay, hash is just, I don't know yet. That's what that icon means, or the pound sign. You could put about us, aboutus.html in lowercase. Okay, but I don't really know what it's going to be called. So if you don't know, just put in hash, and that allows it to be a link, but it doesn't cause an error. Okay, and you can change this later on. Same with contact me, both of them are going to hash at the moment. Don't know. Next thing I'd like to do is turn them on and off at the different views. Because at the moment you can see them all the way through. Mobile, tablet, desktop. So what I'm gonna do is do the mobile one first. I'm trying to double click this, there we go. I want you to turn off, okay, when you're at desktop view. So what I'd like to do is go to my CSS designer panel and my styles.css. In my desktop view, which is global, I want to say, I'm going to create a new selector. And this one's going to be dot mobile. Okay, so this is going to be a class mobile view. Okay, and what I'd like to do is when it's a mobile view, okay, so this is the thing that's going to control this. So mobile view, I would like you to display none. None just means, yeah, I can't see you. So nothing happens, because what I need to do is find the div tag that's wrapping around the outside of this image and apply it. Okay, so where do I do it? I can do it down here. So my image selected, now I've got my div tag selected, and this div needs the dot mobile. Look at that, he's gone. Cool, huh? So this div tag now is now called mobile view div tag. And what we're saying is, when it's a global, which is desktop, I would like you to display none. Okay, and the problem is that it displays none all the time. That's why they call it global and not just specifically desktop. Okay, because what it means is it means everything. It means global, it means everything, unless tablet view says do something different. But at the moment, if I go to my CSS and I look at my tablet view doesn't say anything. So it doesn't override. Mobile view, it's a cascading style sheet, so it flows down and flows over all of these unless they say something different. And they don't. They say mobile view, we don't say anything. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to say on styles.css, when I get to tablet view, the selector named dot mobile view, return again. It's going to, instead of saying none now, we're going to say you apply block. Block is a weird one. It sounds like none. I think block of wood, block of concrete, something solid. I can see it now. Works for me anyway. So I can see it. So let's go and check it in a browser. Live view is not great, remember. Save all, check in a browser. So my mobile menu and desktop view can't be seen. It's none. Now when it gets down to tablet view, it's block. It's a block of wood. Okay, and when it gets down to mobile view, it disappears again. Okay, so what we need to say is styles.css, when it's at the mobile view, which is my maximum of 400 pixels, I'd like to make another selector called dot mobile view. Okay, I'd like to say you are display block as well. So I can see you at both of them. Save all, test, there he is. He's not lined up, that's okay. We'll do the styling later on. It's the mechanics here at the moment. So can't see him, can see him, can see him. Awesome. So what I want to do now is create a new class called desktop view, and I want to apply it to these buttons here, and I want to turn it on and off depending on the view. So let's create a new styles, okay? And I don't want to make it in global. I could, and I could say I'd like you to be block, but it already is block. Okay, I can always see it at desktop view. So I don't need to restate that. What I need to say is tablet turn off. So I'm gonna go to my tablet view, I'm gonna click my selector, I'm gonna call this one desktop view. I did not call it desktop view at all. Return a couple of times. Oh, it's working. Okay, so desktop view, and I'm going to say display none, go away. Now I need to apply it to it. So select on it. Let's click on that div tag that's wrapped around the outside. I'm gonna click here, click full stop, click desktop, and it's not it's not appearing. This happens a bit. If you need to hit save all, okay, and then go back and undo this, and hopefully it's there. Okay, save all, desktop, still not doing it. Okay, I'm gonna leave this in the video just because it happens to everybody. So I'm gonna just type it in physically, hit return. It's gonna say, would you like to create something new? Just keep hitting return on your keyboard until it goes away. Okay, and it is applied. So if I click on this guy, you can kind of see there's my div tag and it's got that class applied. That happens to me a bit in Dreamweaver, just it is. Save all, let's preview in a browser. You can see desktop view, I can see him, but when it gets down to tablet, goodbye, he is none. But he appears back when he's at mobile. So let's do the same thing, styles.css in mobile view. I'd like to create a selector called .desktop, awesome. And I'd like to say, I'd like you to display none, please. Go away. Save all, preview in a browser, gone. Gone there, nice. So that's all we're doing. We've got two div tags, one's called mobile, one's called desktop, and we're just turning them on using display at the different media queries. Okay, so the problem now is this doesn't work yet. Okay, so we're gonna go through now and use some JavaScript to make this a little drop-down button. And make that work. Are you ready for your first bit of JavaScript? Let's go and do that in the next video. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also, on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.